Won't you spare me over till another
Well, that escalated rather quickly. All things are fine in moderation, unless... Lord, what fools these mortals be. We sometimes congratulate ourselves on waking from a troubled dream. It may be so the moment after death. On my travels over many years, I've witnessed many things, seen and heard many beliefs, and there's usually some element of truth in each of them. These unfortunate folk seem to be dealing with forces as yet unexplained. I mean, sinister movements in the forest, spirits from the past, a little girl who may be in trouble. Or maybe she simply is trouble. Anyway, where are we? Angela isn't getting much tittle-tattle out of Taylor. No kiss and tell. What about John? The figure of authority, perhaps. Or perhaps he represents something else. And then there's Andrew. Somewhat confused, I think. A bump to the head can do that. Let me reassure you. You helped make some decisions that will be valued later on. And some that may turn out to be regrettable. That fellow in the bar, he was less than helpful, more than a little rude, if you ask me. Clearly something disturbing on his mind. Enough. There's something not quite right in Little Hope, and souls may be in peril. Off you go again. See if you can lift the fog. Find the bus driver.
Your turn!
Yay! I'm so invested in this, y'all.
I'm so stressed. I'm so anxious.
Little girl, she sounded so strange. I could barely understand her.
Abrasive but understanding.
Abrasive, skeptical, indifferent, and derisive. Derisive.
So abrasive and indifferent. Then, so she's irritating, doesn't really give a shit, and is just skeptical.
I see truthful and understanding also.
That's true. Okay.
All right.
Thank you very much.
You're very welcome.
Sounded like she wasn't from anywhere around here.
I'm tempted to say she sounded more like she was from another time than another place.
You're right.
Okay. I'm just gonna do my usual thing, look for sparklies. I feel like I can probably investigate this car.
Mm-hmm.
If I can't, then that's really disappointing.
Well, I see something shiny.
Right? There's something back there. I really can't do anything with the car. That's like, oh, okay, I was all up
Yeah, it was idea.
All up in the shrubs. Ooh, it's another picture.
All right, y'all. Ooh.
Ooh.
Premonition unlocked. Ooh.
Human sacrifice.
Oh, terrifying. All right.
That's never good.
Was there another one back there?
I don't know.
No.
I don't think so.
Okay, yeah, I thought...
It okay, might have cool. been the flashlight reflecting off something.
Beautiful.
I fall for that a lot. Okay. All right. Can I do anything with the house? We're really not going to investigate this house? Oh. Ooh. I don't like when they just suddenly change the camera angle.
Yeah, right? It's like, ooh, is something gonna pop out at us?
Right, it freaks me out. Like, it's one thing if it's fixed camera angles all the time. Ah! Fucking deer. I fucking hate deer. God.
Might get a better view from up there.
Okay, let's try it.
Oh?
Oh. There's a sparkly.
Ooh, ghost towns of the Northeast. Beautiful. Little Hope, the town returning to nature. The abiding image of a ghost town in the popular imagination of an arid desert shack surrounded by tumbleweed. However, ghost towns exist even in the lush Northeast of the United States, buried away in forest, forgotten and abandoned to nature. The reasons for towns to become ghosts vary, but inevitably comes back to economics. The town may have boomed from logging, mining, or industry. Then the jobs go, and the people with them. The aptly named Little Hope is one such town, a one-factory community built around textiles that disappeared when cheap imports overwhelmed the market. After many attempts to save the mill, it closed, and a mass exodus ensued. Soon, the school and even the church closed, leaving a desolate ruin. Hidden depths. Little Hope is a deserted town, but the forests that surrounded it continue to lure extreme sports enthusiasts. The caverns of Hobbs Deep are famous for ice climbing, but its ice falls are known to be very dangerous. Recommended viewing, Architects of Unreadable. Unreadable, 10:30, 9:30 Central. In this week's episode, Kay Wilder rips the mask off the Zodiac Killer, but will her hard-hitting investigative style unearth any new facts about the notorious killer? Worth watching for the stunning views of San Francisco taken from the Golden Gate Bridge.
Beautifully done.
Thank you.
You're very welcome. Alright. Anything else I can look at?
Ooh.
Looks okay.
Oh, there was something on the middle table.
Oh, was there?
Yeah.
I didn't see anything sparkly.
Oh, it was a damn bottle. Fuck you, bottle.
Damn it, bottle. Damn it, Bobby.
Darn it, bottle.
Wait, is that?
Reflection.
Oh, that's just them.
Ooh. Okay.
Alright.
This tricks you.
It does. Ugh. That's okay.
I keep thinking, is there stuff out there? But no, it's the light lying to us.
How are you coping?
I don't know. What do you think happened to us back there?
I have absolutely no explanation for it. Makes zero sense to me.
What is out there?
We will find a way out of here. We have to.
I hope you're right. Appreciate you checking in with me.
Okay, that's fine. Well, I think that was a very good decision you made.
Thank you.
You improved their relationship, and life is good.
Yay!
You made her stop being an asshole for a second, so I'm very happy and thankful for that.
Aw, yes!
I want to make sure I didn't, like, miss anything out here.
God, you're like Pumpkin. When she doesn't like something, she's like, meh.
Literally. I am Pumpkin in human form.
Meh.
Okay.
Oh.
Our neighbors can fuck all the way off.
The ones right above us left a really sweet note on my car whenever my car got stuck in the snow, and they said, hey, we have a shovel if you need one, so I left them a thank you card. Ooh, the Witches of Edmonton.
The ones right above us can suck my ass.
Little Hope Historical Society presents The Witch of Edmonton, a play by W.M. Rowley, Thos Tucker, and John Ford. Performed in historical dress at Little Hope Middle School, Saturday, 17 April at 7.
Interesting.
Could this have something to do with what we saw?
I guess it could, but it didn't feel like that.
I don't know which is worse. Ghostly apparitions or a town full of historical weirdos.
I just think it's all equally bad. Okay, you upped her uncertain trait.
Because she's still stuck in her old ways.
Exactly. And I think that goes with being indifferent. A lot of the time you don't know because you don't care.
So eventually she'll need to make decisions because a lot of the times you don't have time to really think about stuff. You have to go off of what you're really feeling.
Kind of like how we have to play this game.
Pretty much.
Oh, Jesus. I don't like that. I don't like that it also got dark. Oh, I see you, you little bitch.
Beep.
I saw you.
Beep, beep, beep.
You're not slick. Is there anything? Anything of interest? Anything important? Anything special? No?
Me.
Well, of course. That's a given. That goes without saying.
Bee!
Okay, looks like we're coming up to something.
Looks like we're coming up to my ass.
Oh, no. I'm kind of disappointed that they, like, there's not a whole lot of stuff to look at.
There's something up ahead! Which way? Can we move it?
Amen to that.
Look at that! Hey, wait! Stop!
I'm just gonna say it.
Sorry. The group saw a girl run from them into the darkness of a covered bridge.
This is exactly what goes down in horror movies.
What the hell do we do now?
I'll deal with this. Stay right here.
John confronted the girl at the covered bridge.
Hold up, I'll come with you.
Hey, you two!
This is not good.
Confront the girl. Okay, this should go well. I don't like this. I don't like this one bit. Oh, fuck.
Hey! Anyone there? Hello? Anyone? Get off me!
What is it you want from me? Who are you? What are you doing here? These are most...
Sorry, Angela was intrigued by her lookalike.
Wait, don't go!
Stay away! Me now! Begone, demon. Your spells will not work on me.
Please, Lord, I beg you, rid me of these apparitions.
Who are you? This can't be happening.
Fix your gaze elsewhere. You are no husband of mine.
Let's get into town. It's not so far now, and it's our best shot at getting help.
You guys okay?
I am very far from okay. I am terrified and confused. I just saw my own double in the fog.
What happened in there?
This woman came out of nowhere in the fog, dressed like an extra from Salem. She was garbling something in an accent I didn't recognize, and most disturbing of all, she was the spitting image of me!
How is that even possible?
You're blowing this out of proportion, Angela.
I am all done here.
Seems the fog won't let us go anywhere except into the center of town.
The fog decides where we can and can't go? Fuck that! I'm trying another way.
Don't you kids watch horror movies? You never ever split up.
Those movies are dumb. And I'm going this way without you.
Maybe splitting up isn't such a good idea, Taylor.
No way am I going down there.
I'm with John.
We can check out more options if we split up. I'll go with Taylor. For you to be hanging around here on your own.
Two teams are more likely to find a way out, which is what we all want, right?
I guess you're right. If the fog lets you through, and you find help, send them into town to find us.
All right! We're Andrew again.
Got a feeling we'll find help faster than the others.
As long as somebody does, that's all that matters.
Okay. Traits updated. Angel chose to follow John into the fog. Okay. Alright, so Andrew is altruistic, he's insecure, uncertain, and fearful. Interesting. Alright, well let's get into town. Maybe we'll finally get into town. We spent like 4 videos talking about it.
I know, right? We will actually get into Little Hope.
Finally.
See. Hold up. You hear that?
Thanks.
That was a monster.
Andrew saw Vince ride past on his bike near the covered bridge. Okay. Creepy.
Are we okay here?
We're good. That noise was just the old guy from the bar on his bike.
Stupid old drunk. Somewhere around here, there must be an easier way back up to the road. Let's move out.
Do you even give a shit? Because you literally bolted.
Got an explanation for what we saw?
Nothing that makes sense. I do know there were witch trials in Little Hope around the same time as Salem.
What happened?
You can figure that out for yourself.
What the hell was that?
Now what?
Nope. Oh, that looks good. That's great. Nothing ritualistic about this.
Mm-hmm.
Jesus. Ooh.
Ah! What the fuck?
Oh, I don't like that.
I don't like that one bit.
What's up? You look worried. Are you okay?
Yeah, thanks. I am more or less, but something here just... What we've been through and seen tonight is difficult to stomach. We all have our own way of coping. John here feels the urge to be our leader, the alpha male. Whereas Daniel and Taylor feel an entirely different, somewhat more animalistic urge.
How do you deal with all this?
I'm a natural survivor. Tough marriage and an even tougher divorce will do that to you. Of course, I'm sure you've already worked out that there is only one person you can truly rely on. Yourself.
Don't give up on all of us just yet. If we stick together, we will make it out of this mess.
I'm not sure about that. You know, you sound just like Daniel. We should catch up with John.
Who's Daniel again?
He's the other guy. Mm. That's not the professor. The other student, I guess I should say. Why are you standing there like a fucking...
Are you okay?
Feels like Angela's constantly weighing me up and finding me lacking. I feel responsible for everyone here. You are all in my care. How would you handle all this in my position?
I guess I'd try to stay positive. Do my best, that's all anyone could do.
Not sure my best is up to dealing with whatever is going on around us tonight. What we saw back there, you think that was really supernatural?
It's sure starting to look that way. Creepy little girl in the fog. Then whatever the hell that was back at the intersection?
Just because I can't explain what we saw doesn't mean we have to reach the most extreme conclusion. That's kind of what happened in Little Hope during the witch trials. They made bad decisions based on very little hard evidence.
Sure. I get that.
Either way, our goal here is not proving or disproving the supernatural, ghosts, whatever else. It's getting the hell out of here.
Well, on that note, we're gonna go ahead and end this video here. Hope you guys enjoyed. If you did, please give it a thumbs up, subscribe, share this with your friends, hit the bell so you don't miss an upload, and we'll see you guys next time.
Bye, y'all.
Bye.